Good afternoon, Yorktown. It's Supervisor Matt Slater coming to you live from Town Hall. Hope everyone had a fantastic weekend. I wanted to provide you with an update on COVID-19 and also bring in our highway superintendent who's joining me, Dave Paganelli, to talk about some of the winter weather that we're expecting later this week. The data has not been released yet that we get from the health department that shows the active cases, or really the number of contagious individuals in the town of Yorktown with COVID-19. We do know from the state tracker that yesterday, Westchester County's positive rate was 6.4%. And over the last 7 days, the average of the last 7 days was 5.9%. Now we know that on Friday, we ended the week back at 250, again, active cases, or as I like to explain it, contagious individuals in the town of Yorktown. Again, that's based on the 14-day window, the guidelines set forth by the Department of Health, both for the state and the county. Obviously, any numbers that we get later today will be shared publicly. Again, we share this information so that you can make responsible decisions for yourself, your family, and your neighbors. And that's the important thing for us to do as we continue through this challenging time. Regional hospitalizations, again, according to the state tracker, is at 705 as of yesterday. We heard from the county executive earlier today that as of Saturday, Westchester made up for more than half of the region's hospitalizations with over 358. We were on our Monday call a little while ago with the county executive and municipal leaders, and that number of hospitalizations in Westchester has actually doubled in the last 3 weeks. And so, as I've said before, COVID's not taking the holidays off. Neither can we. We have to continue to take the necessary precautions, make the smart decisions, and do what we know works. That's wearing a mask, that's washing our hands, that's practicing social distancing. And if for whatever reason you're not feeling well, remaining at home and contacting your medical provider. At the end of last week, we heard plans by both the Yorktown and Lakeland school districts. Again, I want to say that they've done a fantastic job, both Superintendent Lyons and Superintendent Hatter, as well as their school boards, their faculty, their staff, everyone involved has just done a great job in our local school districts. But they have announced plans, separate plans for remote learning to take effect. I believe Lakeland is taking effect on the 17th. And Yorktown the following week, and that will extend beyond the holidays. And that's a proactive approach to limit community spread. We do remain in a state of emergency here in Yorktown that does not impact our local schools, businesses, or houses of worship. And our porch pickups at the John C. Hart Library, I do want to share, as part of our state of emergency, the John C. Hart Library has closed to the public, but they are continuing with their porch pickup program. It is from 10 a.m. to 7 p.m. on Mondays and Thursdays, and from 10 a.m. to 5 p.m. on Tuesday, Wednesday, Friday, and Saturday. And so you can order your books either over the phone or online, and you can go pick them up at the John C. Hart Library. And again, I want to thank our staff over at the library for doing a great job to continue to provide important material for the residents of Yorktown. Our staff here, we continue to remain focused on having as many members of our staff work remotely as we can. Government's still operating. Our town services are still continuing. Our staff has done a tremendous job, both in the first wave in the spring, as well as now continuing to uphold their commitment to the residents of Yorktown. And our labor staff is working in different staging areas. We've put together pods for them so that we can make sure that they're safe and they continue to do their duties, and they do a fantastic job. I want to bring in our highway superintendent, Dave Paganelli. We were outside earlier this morning when it was snowing over on Front Street, but we are expecting some winter weather, our first major storm of the season. And of course, 2020 can't go without throwing one more curveball and knuckleball at us. So, Highway Superintendent Paganelli, do you want to provide an update from your standpoint on the weather for the next coming?
Thank you, Supervisor. Yes, we are anticipating a nor'easter on Wednesday, starting about midday, until Thursday morning, about just before noon Thursday. At this point, estimates of snowfall are all over the place. Our best guesstimate based on the 7 sources that we monitor is somewhere between, I would say, 6 and 11 inches. That being said, there's going to be some gale force winds, which if this is a heavy and wet snow, as is anticipated based on the temperatures, could cause some power outages. Hmm. As our chief of police always lets our residents know, that, you know, you've got to be self-sufficient for 24 hours. You can't, you know, make sure you have water, make sure you have batteries, your flashlights. You know, heat will become an issue as it's going to be colder as the evening, you know, progresses. So if you have your generators on, just be very careful with your generators, you know, in proximity to any open windows, because, you know, that's very dangerous and you're not aware of it. So we're prepared. Today was a good shakeout run. We went out, put out a light dusting of salt, you know, because of the blood pressure. No, a light dusting of salt, you know, salt, so that as the temperatures drop now that the sun has set, you know, our roads should be fine. That being said, all the vehicles performed admirably. We have a few little issues, but we have a day tomorrow to address those. So we're prepared. You know, the best you could do for us, and it appears as though the majority of this issue is going to take place in the evening when you should be home anyway. So, you know, we're anticipating having to deal with 2 rush hours, Wednesday rush hour in the evening and Thursday rush hour in the morning. So, you know, just leave a little extra time. Make sure you stay safe. You know, let's make sure, you know, everybody, you know, gets around safely and there's no accidents. And, you know, Highway will do our job with the rest of the town departments helping us. And we'll make sure, you know, that our first shakeout of the year, you know, it'll be a big one. And, you know, it's nothing new. It's something we deal with and we just want to make sure everyone's safe. So I appreciate the opportunity to share this information.
Excellent. You and your crew and the entire workforce always do a great job with our snow events. And so our first one for 2020, our first real one for 2020 coming down the pipe. And again, just to echo what the superintendent said for our residents, just to make sure that you're taking it seriously and taking all the precautions necessary. I know I'll be filling up my gas tank for my generator and snowblower. I started my snowblower up. It turned on, thankfully, yesterday. So we got it ready to go.
They usually work great in the summer. You know,
yeah, I know. That's when I need them in the winter. But again, our first snow event, but we have a great highway superintendent and department who are monitoring the situation, who are ready to roll. And so again, just make sure that everyone's taking the precautions that you need to in advance of Wednesday's storm. Again, we're seeing it mainly from Wednesday afternoon through Thursday afternoon, correct?
Yeah, correct. Yep.
Okay. Fantastic. And as always,
we appreciate you, you know, constantly reaching out to us, asking, you know, what do we need? What can you do to help make things better for us? So, you know, don't think that goes unnoticed and you know, without gratification.
Well, listen, it's a team effort for the residents of Yorktown. I know that the residents appreciate the good work that's been done and the good work that we'll continue to do. Right now, it's about focusing on safety of our residents by making sure that they have all the information they need, whether it's about COVID or whether it's about the coming storm, making those smart decisions, those intelligent decisions, and we'll get through both challenges just fine. Because this is Yorktown. We lead from the front. We work together, and we don't back down from a fight. That's for sure. And we haven't this year, and we're not going to start now, even though we've got this snowstorm on the way, but we've got a good leader in our highway superintendent and a great staff with our workforce. So again, Yorktown, be prepared for power outages, considering the gale force winds. As a reminder, if you do lose power, to contact your utility provider immediately. Don't assume that someone else has already reported it or that they know about it. We've had that incident. We saw that during the hurricane in the summer, where people had expected that someone else, their neighbor, had already reported it. So make sure you contact your utility provider. I spoke with Chief Noble. Our EOC will be up and running. We'll be doing it remotely, which is important for us to make sure that we're maintaining that constant line of communication with the utilities, just to be prepared. And of course, we'll have our staff out there making sure the roads are cleaned and as safe as we can get them, as fast as we can get them. But as for COVID, again, We'll share any new information that we get later this evening, any new numbers that come out or decisions by the state. We were expecting more zones to be handed down by the governor today. That did not happen. In fact, we had good news. The good news was we had the first New Yorker receive the vaccine. So the vaccine is being distributed, which is fantastic. Pfizer's vaccine was approved by the FDA, as well as reviewed and approved by the governor's vaccine committee. And the first, its first application, we got to watch live down in Queens with that was given to an ICU nurse over at LIJ. So we are making progress. There is light at the end of the tunnel. But like I said earlier, COVID's not letting up now, and neither can we. So let's stick together as a community. Let's look out for each other. Let's be good neighbors, and let's make smart decisions. So Yorktown will be back with any new information, verified information, so that you can make those responsible decisions for you, your family, and your neighbors. Until then, stay safe, stay healthy. We'll talk to you soon. Thanks, Yorktown. Thank you, Dave.